What up, guys? Tough Thumbs here. Definitely gonna blow your minds tonight, if last night didn't. But what you see here is my Strider and my buddy's Strider here for work. Quick want to show. Tenacious was here a long time ago. Had the blow liners. It got damaged in the flood. It was the only knife that was exposed to anything. And yeah, it was a whole long story, but anyway, I had it so long I felt really bad, so the dude who owns us, you know, I bought a new one for him. I stonewashed it for you, dude. Nice stonewash on there. And I did a little pattern in the handle scales. They're really nice and grippy. Stonewashed everything inside, and still got the glow stuff all around it. And a stonewash clip. So this will be coming back to you tomorrow. And again, I apologize, man. You know, life happens sometimes, you know. But we'll be getting this very soon. And stonewash this thing. I don't know. I did this in exchange for peanuts, apparently. So gotta thank that guy for that. Also, this is a Strider I've had for a long time. Well, I haven't had for a long time, but it was the first Strider I got, the Pimp, and, you know, I figured I'd go ahead and clean it up a little bit for you, dude. So I stonewashed, or sandblasted all the bolts and everything to match the rest of the blade, and basically looks brand new. The frame side looks brand new, and, yeah, I really want to re-sandblast this blade because it's got a little bit of pitting going on there, so let me know if you want that done, man. Otherwise, I mean... Otherwise, you know, it's gonna rust more on here. So there's a reason I'm showing these, but first, I'm going to get to a Benchmade 710 for a good buddy of everyone here and mine, a fellow knife pimper. It goes by the name of Red Gladius. If you guys haven't seen his work, check him out. He's a good dude. He's definitely up and coming, and he definitely has some skill for sure. So, this thing is red and black, I guess. So it has N. Johansson engraved in the blade there. I guess he got it from Knife Works. And on top you got the ruby red. And on the bottom you got the black G10. And I threw these in just because it looked really classy and nice, I think. I just really like the way this just looked, and I wanted to add something special there. Just two little really subtle, nice, clean glow dots there. Like, I like that. You know, so you'll see it at night, but, like, you know, it's not overwhelming. But I just think it's beautiful. And, the pattern is sort of like the Reptilian pattern, but it's straight. You know, it's straight across instead of, you know, at angles. So it's kind of like a diamond, like, almost a... You know, it still looks like, reptile scales, but... It kind of gives a different effect. You get kind of a diamond look in the middle. I think I'm going to try this more and try to get the point there. It's flat to catch, so it's just straight diamond. So I'm going to try to get it more uniform, maybe look like some of those Japanese patterns people have been asking me to do. But it's also got black liners. Or black spacer material, which looks really nice. Kind of always love when it kind of connects the two. But, it's not much thicker, dude. I tried my best to keep it, you know, but the milling, you know, I just don't, there's been too many times where I've gone way too far and it's, you know, gone through, so, you know, I have to be cautious with that stuff. I mean, you probably know that or will find that out, but, this thing's awesome, dude. I love it. Love it, love it, love it. It's got a great grip, too, and I can't wait to see, your reaction, your unboxing of it, but you see those glow dots on both sides. They're very clean. You can see they're perfectly lined up and everything is seamless. So anyway, guys, moving on. You're gonna like this shit. So these will be for sale exclusively through Neptune Knives website. I will do them, you know, by request, but not now. I'm still waiting on my grinder. I will have it within the month. You guys, I know I've been saying it forever, but, you know, it's coming. I got an upgrade, so, you know, we had to start over. And we're going with a nicer one. I'll be able to do all the tough nuggets you want. Everything you guys, you know, I'll be breaking out knives left and right, and I'll still be doing scales. So I may have to change some things, but I'll still be doing scales because I definitely, my passion is there. I mean, I love knives, and I don't know how it is, but making knives, but yeah, you know, I like the creativity of making scales. And speaking of scales, all right, now, so you see the Striders, and yeah, this one's pretty awesome. So you got a Strider SMG concealed carry. It's your typical, very sexy. It's flamed on one side. This one has the tiger stripe blade. I forget who's this belong to. This belongs to Bobby. Bobby. So yeah, dude, sorry, I just use this for display. Don't worry. I'm also switching out that pivot screw with this one. You see it's nice and clean. Although I don't want to as much now because this one's mine instead of just being just here. But okay, getting to it. Sorry, I'm making you guys wait. So, titanium on both sides. Let's start from this end. Sandblasted titanium with some gnarly ass lines all through it. See, it's contoured. This took a lot of work contouring this thing. It's got a jade backspacer too. But I think this thing. This is the second time I've done a titanium scale. This is the first, you know, besides the 67, this is the first time I've done any other knife. And, you know, getting these things together, you know, a titanium scale, like I said, the first time, it's unbelievable that I actually can do it. You know what I mean? Like, it feels like it's just so much work. But, I mean, it will be a lot easier to do in the future. But I just think this, it always just blows my mind when it gets together. And yeah, you know, you take a knife and it seems to improve every time. This one was, you know, a little bit of blade play, like mine, this one does too. I mean, now it's just like a rock. It just doesn't move. It's just, you know, perfectly centered. And I just think it's gorgeous. And, I was talking to Neptune right before I finished this. It was very shiny and no nothing on it. And we were trying to figure out what we wanted to do on it, and he sent me this picture, and I was like, I can do that. And I thought it'd be cool, because this is kind of like I think this might be for him, but he may be selling on his site. But, you know, this is going to be kind of like oh, that's not even tight. Sorry, guys. I forgot to tighten the pivot screw. Okay, that's better. Yeah, I thought that was too easy. But, yeah, but, you know, he's gonna be showing these to the Strider guys and stuff like that, see what they think, and, you know, see if we can get some stuff going with Strider. You know, I'm liking my Strider guys. I mean, I've never had one before. I mean, I haven't done a whole bunch with it yet, but, I mean, you know, it opens frozen food packages pretty well. But I'm definitely loving this thing. Super comfy. It's a bit thicker because, you know, Gav, me and Neptune were talking about, you know, how thin that is, and he's like, why don't you make it, you know, a little bit thicker? Cause look at that. It's sharp right there. You know, it's just not the most comfortable thing in the world. But this, you know, it's just like the other side. It's nice and thick. A little bit thicker actually, but doesn't add much to it. See, it's still slimmer by far. It's very comfy though, very easy to open. And you know, I put this on the SMG. The pivot screws on these are sanded down, I guess, or like smaller or something. They're the same size, but I guess it sticks out a lot on here. Like, it's the whole thing just pops out. and the screws are longer on this one, so they come through a little bit too much and they stick out too much in the grooves. So they're not completely universal. Some slight mods would make it universal if you, you know, sanded down the ends of the screws. But I'm very happy with this. It just feels awesome. This provides a little bit of grip actually too. But I mean, the concealed carry is supposed to be a smooth, concealable knife. But I think that pattern's really cool too. It's something that has been done before by Strider. So we're trying to go for that look and maybe impress them. But I like it a lot. It's pretty cool. This was very dangerous doing this too. If you can guess, I used a bandsaw and just basically slapped this shit straight on it. It was fun. And Neptune, I re-sandblasted it, and I left it sandblasted because I like the way it looked better than with the slight sanding or whatever. I just think it looks cleaner this way. Yeah, I listen to Tool Guys, one of my favorite bands. As usual, guys, thanks for watching. I will be sending a bunch of stuff out tomorrow. Moonglow Manix guy, dude, did a new pattern on it, didn't work, so I'm just gonna start over from scratch on one of them, but dude, it'll be really worth the wait, so I don't ever want to give you something that's not completely 100% in my mind, so, yeah, can't rush quality, so I didn't have enough room to flip that guy, and Red Gladius will be sending yours back tomorrow as well. So you can make an unboxing and love your new knife. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Have a good one.